And share with you tonight, I want to talk about the importance of having the mentality of a farmer. Yes, a farmer. Because a farmer has a distinct opportunity to reproduce. I want to talk to you for a few moments about the seed, the soil, and the harvest for you. As I think about farmers, I think about how this great nation that we live in rose up from the early days and moved towards the agricultural movement. And as the world progressed, farmers throughout all of the great America came forth and presented their crops. But if you backtrack and understand where the crops came from, it always started with the seed. Class of 2012, you are the seed. You are the seed that has been planted in soil. And as you've been planted in soil, you have to understand that once you go into the soil, you're never the same again. We don't really understand and know what happens when a seed is planted into the earth and it breaks up into all of the molecules and begins sprouting. But we do know that there is a strict transformation that takes place once the seed goes into the soil. So you are the seed class of 2012, and as seed, you have been planted in the soil of your experience, yes, even of your life. And so as you sit here today, you have now begun to sprout into your purpose for the next step. A farmer gets very excited not about the harvest, because he knows that the harvest is going to generate based on his works. What the farmer really gets excited about is the first time the little buds come up out of the ground, because it represents growth and it represents potential for the future harvest. Yes, you are the seed. You are the seed who've been planted because of your parents and because of your caregivers and because of this great nation that we live in. You are the seed that you have been planted. And tonight, we watch you sprout into your next opportunity to maximize your harvest someday. I'm proud to have the chance to tell you that as important as the seed is, the seed is not the most important part of the process. The seed is necessary to get the process started. But the most important part of the process is what you, class of 2012, is what you are about to endeavor into in the next phase of your life. The most important process is the soil. Because the soil is what now the focus must be placed upon. Otherwise, the only way we can help the seed is to dig the seed up. You have been planted. Don't let your seed get dug up. The soil is so important because what happens to the seed to this day forward is contingent upon how the farmer and how the investors manage the soil. As critical as you are as seed, it is important for you to understand that how the soil is nurtured will ultimately determine the outcome of the harvest. The farmer plants the garden using the soil, the seed, and the soil, and then he begins the process of tending the soil. Yes, in this great era of technology and this great era of change, and when we see next technology and we are able to create and do great things, it still comes down to the seed and the soil. Why is that so critical for you to understand? It's because the seed and the soil, it cultivates the process of the relationship. So the farmer has a relationship with the soil, and what he does is he tends the soil because he expects the harvest to develop. And as he tends the soil, he removes things that would choke off the growth. He removes things that would cause the soil not to grow. And now it's time for you to foster relationships, some relationship with people that you've already established. As I look back in my days at Webster High School, and I think about what I do now to make up my life, I don't make up my life, it doesn't consist of running up and down a football field. In fact, I can barely walk up and down a football field right now. But the process that stuck with me as the seed of my life's experience was cultivated by those farmers who were my school teachers, who were my coaches and my parents and my friends in the community. Those farmers helped me become who I am today. As I stand here and use my voice and my experiences to encourage you, I think about some of the farmers who helped me when I was where you are today, when I was a student at Webster High School. Some of those farmers have gone to that great harvest in the sky. Yes, I think about Mrs. Ruth Tibbs, who once told me that until I developed confidence in myself outside of athletics, I would never achieve my goal. I think about Mrs. Tibbs' comments and how she challenged me. I think about a little portly speech teacher who told me someday I would stand and speak before individuals. Yes, I think about Hudson Frederick Wilcox III, who made me stand in front of the class and say things that sounded so ridiculous. Things like Theophilus Thistle, the successful thistle sifter, in sifting a sieve full of unsifted thistles, thrust 3,000 thistles through the flick of his thumb. You're gonna learn how to speak, young man, and I thank him for that. Think about individuals who understood athletics, like Coach Bill Allen, who said to me, "You've only began, Vince. The problem that you have to face is not where you're going, but to always remember where you come from, Vince, young man." I remember Coach Allen saying to me, "No matter where you go, you'll always be part of where you came from." And I think about those farmers who implanted in my life, and all of these years later, as I think about this great technology, I think about those individuals. You need to reflect upon individuals who have been planning in your life, class of 2012. Today, the class of 2012, we need to challenge you to embellish the harvest from the over 18 years of labor that began with the seed of your educational process. Yes, good, better, best. Never let it rest till your good gets better and your better gets best. Soil is the essential component by which the progression of your harvest was nurtured. It's the tending of the soil. The tending of your soil. That's so important. I want to give you some things as I conclude. The key elements that of tending your soil has to do with continuous improvement. Continuous improvement are some of the bullet points that will help you as you learn how to manage the soil in your life. And as you look at continuous improvement processes, you have to remember that you have to define, measure, analyze, improve, and control your soil. I say that again, define and measure, analyze and improve and control. You need to see problems as opportunities. You need to ask why a minimum of 5 times. You need to ask why a minimum of 5 times, and then ask yourself, why not? Recognize that everyone has ideas. Embrace the concept that fixed ideas should not exist. Because changes brings about changes in fixed ideas. Do not accept waste. Don't waste your time. Don't waste your energy. And know, whatever you do, don't waste your opportunity to tend your soul. Remember that excuses are old school. I said excuses are old school. What that means is that we can always say why we never could before, but when that becomes an excuse, that's old school. And old school needs to yield to new thought processes. Remember that change is good and change is needed. Correct mistakes immediately. If you don't know how to correct mistakes, ask for help if you need it. But whatever you do, as they say, get her done. Continuous improvement is never ending. We never arrive. We just apply relentlessly in pursuit of being better. Yes, good, better, best. Never let it rest till your good gets better and your better gets best. Remember, never let it rest until your good gets better and your better gets best. Congratulations, Daniel Webster High School class of 2012. We look forward to seeing you in your future endeavors. Now you go.
He is undercover, the greatest thing that ever happened. to me. Show some love in this house. Listen, don't you wait.